Let me share with you some things that might help you with your journey in moving to Greenville. If you have a child with special needs or you have somebody in your family with special needs, I call it a journey because it takes a family and it takes a village a lot of times when you have a child with special needs to make sure that they're raised well and they have the things and the services that they need to thrive. In this video, I'm going to unpack things that have helped us with our daughter, who's now 23, almost 24 years old, and the different ways that it has impacted our family. And it may help you make your decision, and it may help you decide not to move here. I'm not sure that that may or may not be the case because I don't know your situation and I don't know their special need. But if this video can help you, I'd be glad to give you all the information I possibly can. Let's go ahead and jump into it. If this is your first time to the channel and you want to know everything about the Greenville area, then make sure you hit subscribe and tap the bell for notifications so you can be the first to know everything about the upstate. I'm Tracy Roberts with the Atlas Home Team, and we'd love to help you have a smooth transition. Whether it's a week from now or a year from now that you're moving here, make sure you reach out. All of my information is below and we'd love to help you. In no particular order, I'm going to unpack some services that have made a great impact on our daughter, Mackenzie. She's 23, almost 24, so these are going to be various age brackets these things have helped her with and continue to help her with for some of the things. One of them is Mauldin Miracle League. Mauldin Miracle League is an amazing community. And well, I call it a community because it ranges in ages and it's for all developmental delays or special needs. So you could be in a wheelchair, you could have autism, you could have Down syndrome, various different services that are needed for you are all supported in a high manner there. It is over at Sunset Park. It's phenomenal. The field has it to where wheelchairs can easily get onto it. Children can play on the playground that's named after the Mauldin Miracle League right next door. The information, I'll make sure I put a link in the description. You'll want to have your child thrive out there and enjoy the fresh air and be with children and some adults. You want to have that. And if you want to make sure that they're in a community that they're loved for them, that is so amazing for her. Watching her little face light up and her cute pigtails wag back and forth when she was trying to hit her baseball was so cool, and her excitement when she got to hit it. She didn't care that she was getting assistance to hit the ball. She just knew she hit the ball. And so sometimes it takes a community and a village to help them hit that ball. One of the amazing services that she gets to enjoy now is David's Table, or E210. That is an amazing organization that meets on Monday evenings, and they have dinner together and they do worship together, and they get to have the word of God spoken to them in a way that they understand it, that they can align with other people with special needs. It ranges from people that are under 18, and then they move up into a different category when they're over 18 and out of high school. So that way everybody is able to be around their ages and acclimate to each other. There's different things that go in throughout the summer and different camps they get to go to. They genuinely care about our children. They care about our families. It's a community, and I don't know what we would do without them. I don't want to leave off the school system. The school system has been phenomenal for Mackenzie. She's no longer in school, obviously, because she's 23. You age out at 21 in the state of South Carolina, or they can stop at 18. That's what Mackenzie decided she wanted to do. Not because the school wasn't great. There are different programs inside the school for inclusion. There are neurotypical children that create clubs. So at the Mauldin Middle School, it's called Impact. It's phenomenal. She met wonderful, beautiful children, neurotypical and special needs. Her best friend is Fall. Her name is Autumn. Somehow Kinsey correlated that with obviously fall, because fall is autumn. So she never called Autumn her name. She called her Fall. And it was the cutest thing. And they stayed friends even after Autumn has graduated college. And it's just really cool. So Mackenzie also went to Woodmont High School, which is Be a Fan, is what their club is called. They have where neurotypical children go into the classroom and help special needs children. They also help them with different activities like prom, the football games, just living life. And if they need to go between classes and stuff like that, they make them feel included. They never make them feel ostracized. It is a safe zone for them. And I was definitely amazed at how embraced she was. And so I'm not saying every school is like that and every child is like that. I'm just telling you that I have the best memories of dropping Mackenzie off at school and feeling safe and secure that she was with the right teachers and with the right faculty and the right staff, as well as students around her, to make her feel whole by the time she came home. Another program in our area is called Camp Spearhead. Mackenzie has gone since she was, I think, 11 years old. That's a long time, maybe 12, because I may have been a helicopter mom for a little bit longer. So it is in Marietta, South Carolina, not Georgia. And it's next to Camp Greenville. And it's really a unique place. It's for ages, I think, 11 or 12, and it doesn't age out. So there's cabins for the boys and there's cabins for the girls, and they get to get dropped off Monday mornings at 9 a.m., well, between 9 and 11, and picked up on Fridays between 9 and 11. You're knowing that your child is safe, getting their medications if they need it, they're going to have showers, they're going to have all the things that they need to support them as they need, and they're getting to go canoeing, they're zip lining, hiking, swimming, all of these things, they're making crafts, they're learning all these things with their peers, and having buddies. Mackenzie is so excited to go. She gets to go two times this summer. We always figure out how to make one go in June and one go in July because we know how much it means to her. They also do things on the weekends in the fall, on Saturdays, and there's also the spring program. So they have the bowling, they have where you can go to Furman. It's just a really great organization that gives back to the special needs community, and it is less expensive if you live in Greenville County than if you live out of Greenville County. Just know that. Special Olympics. Now, while there's Special Olympics everywhere, Special Olympics is fully embraced in the school system here, and I mean at a high level. She did bocce ball, she did basketball, lots of different things, but they really include them, as well as include the neurotypical children that help them as buddies. They help them go to Myrtle Beach and Columbia, where Fort Jackson is, and all the different places. Special Olympics are a big deal here, and they're really, really supported at a high level. So if your child is in Special Olympics and you're moving to the area, don't fret. They're totally going to be supported here, and you can get them in the right schools to get them connected to Special Olympics. It can be very difficult to know what services your child needs, what different delays it has. Does it need to have autism as a diagnosis? Is it ADHD? Is it neither of those? What special needs are they dealing with so they can get the services they need? BabyNet and Kidnetics are phenomenal for that. They're located in downtown Greenville, and they help them get ABA therapy, which is applied behavior therapy. They help them get speech therapy. They help them get physical therapy, occupational, all kinds of different things that they help them get. They help them get into schools, whether it's the public school system at an earlier age in the special needs programs, or do they get them in the Meyer Center, or do they go to Hope Academy? They will be your liaison to get you where your child needs to be. They're definitely a resource you want to look into if you're moving to the area or if you're already in the area. And last but not least is Brookwood Church. Brookwood Church is so dear to our heart. They have done so much for the special needs community. They have special friends on Sundays, but they don't stop there. They do hoedowns. They do the superheroes. They have all these crazy things that they do for the children on Fridays. And it's usually every 2 to 2.5 months that they do these things. I don't know how they have the energy for all this stuff. They rent out the water park for them. They do so many things. On the hoedown, it was ridiculous. They had the hay rides for them. All the adult volunteers are dressed up. Even on superheroes, they're dressed up, and the kids are so excited. Like, you have to hold Kenzie's hand and slow her down from going, okay, Kenzie, we have to walk. She wants to be in there. And it is where your child can thrive, whether it is 8 years old or it is 28 years old. You will be able to know that your children are taken care of, and you can get respite time. They're going to have either rooms for you to get respite, where if you want to say, okay, I don't trust yet, I'm going to leave them in that room, but I'm still going to be over here. We know, Mama. I get it. I've been there. Then you're going to get to a next level where you say, okay, I've done it a couple times that way. I trust they're going to be okay. And then you can leave for a couple hours, and that's respite care that you can go, whether it's get your nails done, get a moment to yourself. Mama, I get it. I've been there. I wouldn't get it today, but I've been there. But I would say, Brookwood has made a huge impact on our family. It's also been where they've held the Night to Shine, that where they have the prom with Tim Tebow's organization. That was the first time my daughter ever wore makeup. It was the coolest experience to dress her up and curl her hair and put makeup on her and watch her in her own little sassy self be able to go dance and have fun and have a prom with her peers. So I would say Brookwood Church has made a huge impact on our family as well. These are not the only services in the area. These are just the ones that were top of mind that I wanted to make sure that I got out there, because it's very hard sometimes to find services when you're moving to an area. If you ever have any questions about services in Greenville County, make sure you reach out to me. If I don't know, I do know somebody who will, and I'll get you supported. I promise you that. So there you have it. That's my take on what it looks like to have special needs services in Greenville, South Carolina. If you're thinking about moving here anywhere in the upstate and you need some help, I'm Tracy Roberts with the Atlas Home Team. All of my information is below, and we'd love to help you. Reach out to us.